In this video, I am going to just generate an m orbital. So we have done some calculation previously, so we will try to see how we can generate. So there is a very good option. You have to just load your log file, you have to select this orbital option, you have to just go to a new Gaussian mo method, load MOs from existing FCHK file, which path already I have given. Okay, oh my god, I have done something wrong. So yes, new Gaussian, load, loading is done. Now we have to just visualize them, visualization, and I am just like taking LUMO and HUMO, highest occupied molecular orbital and lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. Let me just update it. And it will take some time. Yeah, so let me just make it somewhat big so that everybody can see. So now we can just go to our this one. We can go, okay, so this is our, okay, we can adjust our ISO value like this way. Okay, okay. Okay, so this is the way we should be like. Okay, so now this is our HUMO, and LUMO we want to see. LUMO is already like it is a sphere, and HUMO you can see it have one node which is containing the oxygen atom. So it is actually formed by the atomic orbital overlap of oxygen and sulfur, hydrogen. So that is a very simple way to generate an HUMO of in this way. Or you can also generate, if you want to generate, you have to just select those, I think. So you can always generate, and this is the way you can, you have to just find out the MO diagram. So the all the calculation I have done, it is just making a simple calculation and just then selecting the right MO. So if you have any questions and comment, please do write in the comment section and post, and like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I think I have covered all basic aspects of GaussView. So thank you for watching my videos. Hope you like it.